Morning guys, how are you doing? Are you guys just that person in the house? You know, in every house, there's always that one person that's the go-to guy whenever there's a problem that no one can be bothered to sort out. I'm definitely that guy, and it's like, people come to me in this house and they're like, Alex, I've got a problem with something, can you sort it out? It's not like I've got my own bloody problems to sort out. Look, this LED strip here is flashing. I don't know if you can see that, like behind there. You see the flash? Yeah, you can see it there, that's flashing. Then what's up with that? This one in here, well, I had a bath last night, spilled a load of water, so I need to clean all that up. And then, these two LEDs have just stopped working altogether. They've just given up on life. And then, I thought it was just gonna be these two. Oh, but no. He started, hasn't he? He's off on a Madden. What are you doing? I think I found the culprit. It's this LED controller. Luckily, I've got a spare set of LEDs down here, which I don't use. So, I'm gonna try this controller here with the LEDs behind the bed. There we go, so hopefully my iPhone cable should be where I leave it when I get to bed tonight. Right, so apparently on the front door, something came off here, which makes it make a horrible noise when it closes. Ouch. I've got the solution, Velcro and scissors. What I think we're gonna do is just cut a bit of Velcro off here, like that. So that's the door fixed, and my LEDs behind the bed are fixed. That's two jobs down. What's the other one? Oh yeah, those. I don't even know where to begin with those. So a lot of you have been saying to me, you know, Alex, where the hell is part three of the lads' holiday? Now, I promise you guys part three is gonna be probably the best part out of the four-part series, and I'm currently editing it right now, and I wanna give you guys a bit of a sneak preview. Now, the timeline, as you can see, it's fairly chunky and messy. It's a big edit, but I'm really happy with it, how it's coming along. It's not color corrected yet. This is just still raw out of the camera, but I want to give you guys a bit of a taster. So without further ado, let's do this. Absolutely awesome, and yeah, that's all I've got to get to tell you guys. That's all I can tell you guys, really. I don't want to break, you know, any secrets. I'm going to show you that, and that's your sneak preview. But anyway, question time. Right, so I'm going to start to include my weekly Q&A session into the vlogs, because it just, like, makes it easier. Like, in my books, you're either a vlogger, or you do, like, one-take videos, like, all professional videos. And I do more vloggy type videos, and I still like to do Q&As, so the best thing to do with that is to include the Q&As in these vlogs. So if you didn't know, if you want to ask me questions, the way to do it is get yourself on Twitter and type out the question with the hashtag AskMars, and yeah, that's it. Ali asks, could you give me some advice for my YouTube channel? Now, see, got you, Ali. Right, you need to get on my vlog channel, my actual, like, one-take vlog channel. I'll drop a link in the description. And on there, I've done a video about how you can improve your channel and how to be successful, in inverted commas, at YouTube. So I did a video on there. If you want to go and check it out, the link will be on my vlog channel in the description. That didn't make sense. The link for my vlog channel will be in the description, so you can go and watch the video about that on the vlog channel. It's in the description. Yannick says, what did the sea say to the other sea? Nothing, they just waved. Do you see what I did there? I'm sure you did. Wow. Dodorous asks, Most anticipated video game of this year. And will you ever get back into gaming? A setup like that going to waste? Well, I actually do game on that setup, believe it or not. I just don't videotape me playing games. I just don't find it very entertaining to do. But I do game on this setup and I do it in my spare time, which I don't have a lot of at the moment. I'm like editing and always making these videos for you guys and working, which is my passion and what I want to do. My most anticipated game of this year will be Black Ops 3, but not Black Ops 3 for Black Ops 3, Black Ops 3 for Zombies. I'm a huge Zombies fan, and when my internet gets sorted out, which the people were meant to come around today to do it, and they just haven't shown up. So I was meant to be able to do a live stream tonight, but obviously they haven't shown up, so that's... But yeah, I do want to get back to streaming some Zombies and doing that, because I really do enjoy playing Zombies, and so Black Ops 3 is my most anticipated game for this year. LSAT Pro asks, Alex, on your vlog channel, why is the URL /Velocistar? What is with that name? Well, I actually made that name when I was about 10, and it's a really old YouTube channel, and you can't change the URL name, you can only change the name of the channel. So the URL name is Velocistar, I made it when I was 10, don't judge. Just Me and the TV asks, what countries are you planning on visiting in your gap year? So number one, I'm definitely going Australia. Australia is going to be a big chunk of my gap year. I'm going to be going there for about, I don't know, maybe like four or five months, just after Christmas, going to be heading off to Australia and being with Barney for like 4 months, 5 months in Australia, which is going to be absolutely insane. I'm going to also hit up Amsterdam, I want to go to Paris, and I want to go to New York, and I want to live in New York for a good 2 weeks and just like see how awesome it is, because everyone that lives in New York says it's absolutely awesome. Georgina asks, what is it like being friends with Syndicate? Now, so here's the thing, I'm not really like friends with Syndicate, but he knows who I am, and I very much know who he is, but the key is in that sentence is, he does know who I am. If he saw me, he would call me Alex, and that is like a privilege, like having someone like of that magnitude be able to like know who you are and recognise you. So I was actually sat on his table for a little bit at the pub quiz at I-55, because I know Ashley Marie Gaming quite well, so I was sat with her, and so Syndicate was there, and he just goes and buys people drinks, and he's like, He's generally such a chill guy. Like honestly, one of the chillest guys you'll ever meet. So is KSI. Like I think KSI takes the crown for being the most chillest guy, but then the most mental in his videos. Like he's crazy online, but if you meet him in real life, he's just like super chill and laid back. It's really a bit weird. Aaron asks, are you a massively confident person? Now that is a really, really strange question, and it's been something that's been on my mind for quite some time. So obviously in these YouTube videos, I'm very confident. If you didn't know me personally, you'd think, Jesus, that Alex is confident, maybe a little bit too confident and maybe a little bit cocky. But no, in front of a camera, you know, I'm so confident. Like with you guys, I love you. I feel like we're all like a massive group here, and I'm confident. And you know, I get a few comments saying, Alex, you're a little bit too confident, you're a little bit cocky sometimes. And no, that's not the case. Like if you met like any of my real life friends, I was talking to Barney about this about 3 days ago, and we were talking about how underconfident I am in talking to people in real life. Like I'll start to stutter and I'll start to like break up, not know what to say. Like I think I was out in town with him actually, and Barney was going off and talking to all these new girls and meeting some new friends, and I was just sat there having a drink, and Barney was like, Come and talk to these people. Like, just come over and chat. And I'm really like a socially awkward person. In front of a camera, I'm absolutely awesome. But the thing is, confidence is a great thing, right? Because being confident means that people will have respect for you. It means that people will look up to you. It means that people like you. People don't like someone that's underconfident. People don't want to have an underconfident friend, right? So the great thing about confidence is you can pretend to be confident. You can put on a confident front and no one will know the difference. Deep down, you could be absolutely bricking yourself. But on the surface, if you're confident, no one can tell the difference. Right, I'm gonna wrap this Q&A up today, guys. Drop your questions with the hashtag AskMars on Twitter if you wanna be in next week's episode. Right, so I'm currently rendering the lad's holiday in 4K. 11 minutes. Let's do this thing. So I just put a tweet out to Twitter. If you don't follow me on Twitter, it's at Mars Bar Gaming, I really suggest you do, because I keep you guys updated on Twitter all the time. But I just put on Twitter that it's a monumental moment when your video makes it on the homepage of YouTube. So yeah, a video of mine was literally on the homepage of YouTube. I logged out of my YouTube channel and it was on the front page. Let me try it now. There it is, on the front page of YouTube. I got robbed whilst making a YouTube video and it has over 1 million views. This is how you make a video that gets over 1 million views, right? Literally, the title says it all. If you haven't seen that video, I really do recommend you check it out, because it's like one of the first videos I ever made when I started vlogging. And literally, I started vlogging and we got robbed. And that I put it online and it's got over 1 million views. Like, what? Like, that is insane.
Oh, guys, I'm really happy. So on the topic of
getting 1 million views on a YouTube video,
Barney, one of my best mates, he's literally like such a legend, he's been like a massive inspiration to me. He's just created his YouTube channel, he's got no subscribers at the moment, and he's just done his first video, Bangkok in 6 hours.
Now, he's actually in Australia for a year now. He's going on a gap year and he's inspired me to take my gap year. I'm gonna go out and see him in a bit, but he's just uploaded his first video right now, called, what's it called? Bangkok in 6 hours. So, here we go. My internet's not really working, but this is Barney's video. If you guys want to go and check him out, I'll drop a link in the description. Guys, go and feel free to subscribe to him. I'm sure he'd really appreciate it. He'd definitely appreciate a comment and a like for it, and he'd definitely appreciate a sub from you guys. So, he's going to be trying to make videos, like, while he's away and touring the world, like I'm going to be. So if you guys want to go and check out Barney, there's his channel. I forgot my camera.
Cute. Go down to the post office, get it weighed, put all the stamps on, address it to me, take all the stuff out.
So this pole up, what I can do
is hold the camera out like that, and then it gets it nice and away so we can take a photo. Cool, isn't it?
Yeah.
BSA Scorpion.
Yeah, that's the one.
All right, go on then.
Ready?
Yep.
Oh, Dad.
So guys, I hope you enjoyed today's video. I'm just finishing today off. I'm on Skype with Rob and we are discussing the new TechFlow banner. Now, if you're not aware of what TechFlow is, it's what the tech channel is going to be called. It's obviously getting rebranded because we're turning it into a little bit of a business, getting all products and stuff from companies. So TechFlow is the new name of the tech channel. That's going to be rolling out an update very soon. So if you're not subscribed to the tech channel, I'll drop a link in the description. But yeah, I hope you've enjoyed today's video, guys. If you have, a like very much appreciated. And if you've got any questions, the comment section is the place. My name's been Alex. You guys have been awesome. And I'll see you in my next video. Adios.